if you look at the current existing joint ventures, the equity participation of Thales is around 26%. Now, given the fact that the current FDI policy, you know, lets one actually scale it up to 100% theoretically, mm-hmm. up to 49% you can go and do it in through the automatic route. So, do we see equity participation in joint ventures with BEL or Samtel or L&T Technologies being scaled up by Thales? And how will the structure of the new joint ventures that you are proposing, will it see higher equity participation?
Yeah, you can expect us to be really willing to substantially invest in India. Mm-hmm. So we will use all the opportunities that the Indian policy is offering mm-hmm. to increase our participation. Mm-hmm. Of course, this requires to be in agreement with our partners. So we have existing joint ventures. As you rightly said, our current participation in these joint ventures is 26%. Mm-hmm. If our partners actually welcome the fact that Thales would increase their participation, we're willing to consider that. Mm-hmm. For new joint ventures, we might directly consider a higher participation than 26%. Mm-hmm. Of course, 26 is linked to the previous regulation.
Yes,
no?
Yes.
So now we have more opportunities to invest at a higher level. Mm-hmm. And we're also prepared to have entities and investments in India in which we would have a controlling stake.
Right.
So this is... we are very flexible in the way we will organize our investments in India. Mm-hmm. The message is that we're prepared to significantly invest in this country.
Right.
We need to act according to the rules, and obviously we will make sure that we'll fulfill our offset obligations through all these investments.
Right. You know, how much investment then could we see as from the point of view of Thales in the Indian market? Can you give us a sense of that as well? Because as you said,
we've not communicated any number, but you can expect that to be a large size investment. We see India as a very important country to us. India is a very fast growing country, very large country, mm-hmm. And India has lots of needs in all the areas of activities of Thales: defense, security, aeronautics, space, air traffic control, transportation. So it's very natural for Thales to be prepared to invest substantially in the country.
Yeah. Well, one last question on the Rafale deal. You know, and this question is not related to Rafale deal directly. India now says that it perhaps would need 200 more aircrafts. We have Lockheed Martin saying that, please, you know, we are willing to offer you the F-16 assembly line. The Swedes are offering the Gripen assembly line to India. Do you think that the Rafale consortium should also pitch this aircraft for this new contract that would be coming up in the future?
Well, of course. Since India will have these 36 Rafale, it makes quite a lot of sense mm-hmm. for India to continue to use this type of solution, this type of aircraft for their new project. So yes, we expect the Rafale to be considered for the new purchases of
right.
The Indian government. Absolutely.
Right. Okay. Now let's talk about Thales's participation in India. I mean, you were talking about how you see India as a very important market, and hence I would like to dwell more on that. You have what is known as a go-to-India approach as far as India is concerned. What does it mean? And currently, from what I understand, around in India contributes about 2.5% of the Thales global turnover.
Mm-hmm.
Where do you see that going up? How much do you see that going up by? If you can give us a sense of that.
Yes. Well, we have, in fact, a policy that is focusing on India. There are several aspects to it. We certainly see India as a large market. Mm-hmm. So we plan to grow our presence in the country to address the Indian market.
Mm-hmm.
And what we believe, for example, and I've mentioned it already, India has obviously huge needs in the field of ground transportation, huge needs in the field of air traffic control. Thales is the largest supplier of air traffic control solutions in the world. So we certainly believe it makes sense for us to really support the policy of the Indian government in that field. We were very happy to see that the Indian government has issued a new national civil aviation policy, and we plan to support that quite substantially. So first of all, India is certainly a very large market for us. But also, India, in addition, is going to be a stronger and stronger contributor to our supply chain.
Yes.
We will carry out more work internally through Thales subsidiaries in India, but we also plan to purchase much more through joint ventures or through relationship with a number of Indian companies.
Which means the exports from all these subsidiaries, that will go up in the future.
Yes, absolutely. We will purchase more from Indian companies, and we expect also to be able to position these Indian companies on Thales projects for market outside of India, and we also expect our joint ventures to be able to address markets outside of India.
Right.
So we are very impressed, actually, with the pace of development of Indian companies. We know a wide range of companies. Some of them are very large-sized companies, public sector or private sector. Other companies are SMEs. And I must say we are very impressed with the dynamism, innovation capabilities of a number of Indian SMEs, and we believe it really makes sense for Thales to develop a stronger relationship with all these companies.
Right.
So basically the go to India approach for Thales means that you will see Thales even more in the future in the Indian market, but you will also see Indian companies having much stronger links with Thales for projects that are, of course, concerning the Indian market, but not only the Indian market, also basically addressing the global market.
Okay. Now let me talk to you about, as you were talking about, Thales is not just about defense-related projects in India. You have huge stakes in infrastructure projects, specifically in railways and in aviation. Let me start with railways. Indian government has been pushing railway infra development very strongly. Where does Thales stand in that? What kind of opportunities do you see in that?
Well, Thales supplies control systems for trains, as well as telecommunications and monitoring systems, plus a number of equipment. So we are already involved in India for metro projects. in several cities, as well as mainline projects. Obviously, we plan to continue to support the Indian investments in these fields for both metros and mainline investments. So this is, depending on programs and projects, in fact, you will see us either as a system supplier for a train control system, mm-hmm. or you will see us as an equipment supplier. It depends. And we have various ways of contributing to all these projects.
So, you know, right from defense to railways, ATC related equipment, clearly Thales has set its sight on the Indian market and has a clear strategy. Clearly, you'll be expanding in the Indian market. We'll have to wait and see what kind of joint ventures and engagements would be announced from the Thales point of view in the coming months. Thank you so much for joining us, ma'am.
Thank you.
And wish you all the best. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.